Philippine House lawmakers believe the high-level U.S. trade mission is just a preview of more potential investments to the Philippines. They insist once the Constitution has been amended, more foreign firms will express interest in the country.
Ngayon pa lang na we are discussing this, habang wala pa, may investment na pumapasok. What more? Once these restrictions will be lifted, all other countries are now going to see na we are worth investing.
Yung lahat ng foreign trips ng presidente, that should not be in vain, no? I think the House, the Congress, especially that we are supportive of this administration's policy.
Their bullish remarks come as the push for charter change moves forward in the lower chamber. But at least one House lawmaker remains firm in her opposition to the ongoing effort.
Sa research natin, no, at least 6% na lang po. 6.2% na lang yung hindi open for foreign investment po doon sa ating ano, no, doon sa ating study. This is a constituent assembly. The House of Representatives and the Senate should convene jointly and vote separately.
Meanwhile, the historic American trade and investment missions to the Philippines ends with high praise from the delegation for what it sees as Manila's business-friendly environment. Jackie Pascual reports.
U.S. Commerce Secretary Gina Raimondo ended the high-level presidential trade and investment mission thanking the Philippine government for a more welcoming business climate for American companies. Though she did not mention the previous administration, which distanced itself from the U.S., Raimondo says she is happy with the developments under the Marcos Jr. administration.
President Marcos, it seems to me, is doing all the right things to make your country more business friendly, easier to do business in, and that's just music to our ears in the U.S. and to the delegation that I brought. I'm just really excited by what I'm seeing on the ground, and this is actually the very first ever presidential mission on behalf of the United States to the Philippines. So it's a historic mission in that respect.
She added that recent laws, like the amended Public Services Act, are also good measures to attract more foreign investments.
The message that we are hearing, you know, the legislation that the Philippines has passed allowing for private sector ownership of infrastructure makes public-private partnerships easier. And it, I have to tell you, it sends a huge signal to the United States that the Philippines wants more investment.
Ayala Corporation Chairman Jaime Augusto Zobel de Ayala agrees, citing stronger Philippine-U.S. economic ties.
Your visit, Secretary Raimundo, also marks a significant shift in the direction that both the Philippine government and business sector have embarked on. In just the last 3 years, we've seen a rekindling of this relationship.
Various business groups met with Raimondo and said her visit signals renewed trust and confidence between the two nations.
Ease of doing business in the Philippines has improved. The legislation that's been passed has made it easier for foreign investors to come in and invest in almost any sector.
From an American Chamber standpoint, times are good. All the stars are aligned.
Raimondo also said the U.S. is now looking at more countries for the expansion of its semiconductor sector, which includes the Philippines.
The U.S. companies have realized that our chip supply chain is way too concentrated in just a few countries in the world. Forget about geopolitics. Just at that level of concentration, you know, it's the old adage, don't put all your eggs in one basket. And that's the opportunity for the Philippines. Philippines already has 13 semiconductor assembly, testing, and packaging facilities. Let's double it.
22 American companies joined the high-level trade mission, including Microsoft, Google, Visa, MasterCard, FedEx, UPS, and United Airlines. Raimondo said the companies will invest a total of over $1 billion worth of investments, which include training and skills development programs. Jackie Pascual, ABS-CBN News.
America's top diplomat Anthony Blinken set to visit the Philippines in the coming weeks. U.S. Commerce Chief Gina Raimondo revealed this during a meeting with Filipino and American firms in Makati City. Raimondo says visits of U.S. officials to the Philippines point to the importance of Manila as Washington's partner. But she did not mention the specific date of Blinken's arrival. Blinken's upcoming trip to the Philippines will be his second official visit since August 2022. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. denying that Manila rejected China's proposals on resolving issues in the West Philippine Sea. Marcos set the record straight as he spoke to reporters in Germany. He said he will continue to defend the country's territory despite repeated harassment from China at sea.
We have not rejected any proposals that China has made to us, but the premise is something that we question. And that premise that China has made is that their territory is follows what is now described as a 10-dash line. This is not recognized by any country, any international body, certainly not by the Philippines. Our baselines have been well established for years now. We have the economic zone that China has already intruded upon. And until that premise that China has made in terms of all its discussions with the Philippines, then it's very difficult to see a way forward.
The Foreign Affairs Department meanwhile confirmed receiving concept papers from Beijing last year, but it says the proposals went against Manila's national interests. As for Germany, Chancellor Olaf Scholz expressed support for the Philippine government in protecting its rights in the West Philippine Sea. A 2016 arbitral ruling found Beijing's sweeping claims in the South China Sea had no legal basis, but China continues to reject that decision. Over now to the West Philippine Sea, the Philippine military says over 50 Chinese ships and fishing boats were spotted in the vicinity of the Scarborough Shoal, Ayungin Shoal, and Pag-asa Island as of Monday. Despite this, the armed forces vows to continue its rotation and resupply missions to Filipino fishermen and troops within the country's exclusive economic zone. Earlier this month, a Chinese Coast Guard ship fired a water cannon and collided with a Philippine resupply vessel. Four Filipinos were injured in the incident.
Following the last roré in Patag and Lawak stations in last February 18 to 21, the Western Command Armed Forces of the Philippines is now preparing another roré at Rizal Reef and Likas stations on 03 to 06 March 2024. On the other hand, the next roré at Pag-asa, Kota, Panata, and Parola will be conducted in the first week of April.
Controversial religious leader Apollo Quiboloy given 48 hours to explain why he should not be arrested by the Senate. Senator Risa Ontiveros issued the show cause order Tuesday night after meeting with Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri regarding the ongoing Senate probe on Quiboloy's alleged crimes. It will be served to Quiboloy today, March 13th. The Senate earlier cited Quiboloy in contempt over his repeated snub of the upper chamber's inquiry. Over at the lower chamber, a House panel has approved a bill seeking to revoke the franchise of SM&I, which is believed to be owned by Apollo Quiboloy. The network has been accused of violating provisions of its franchise by allegedly airing fake news as well as transferring controlling interest without Congress approval. But SM&I firmly denied the allegations.
The six hearings that we have conducted, this committee has found sufficient grounds to revoke their franchise.
What is controlling interest is 50% plus. What was transferred is only 46%. Definitely 46 is different from 50% plus. There is no need to secure the prior approval of Congress. Number two, yung fake news daw. Alam mo yung mga words doon na dapat bantayan natin, willful dissemination. Deliberate dissemination. Wala naman nangyaring ngayon. Humingi na nga ng pasensya.
The bill will still have to pass the House plenary second and third readings, as well as get the nod of the Senate and the President. Meanwhile, Kibuloy was again a no-show during Tuesday's hearing, prompting the House committee to cite him in contempt.
Why does the good pastor refuse to come?
He is apprehensive that his rights may not be respected because of the frenzy surrounding the investigation. To show our good faith and our due respect to this honorable committee, we have brought with us three persons who are in the best position, more than Pastor Kibuloy, and who have been the ones active since 2022 in the affairs of the Kingdom of Jesus Christ.
11 Filipino seafarers now back in the Philippines, nearly a week after surviving a Houthi missile strike off Yemen. They were crew members of the Barbados-flagged merchant ship True Confidence, which was attacked last week, killing three, including two Filipinos. They were the first fatalities since the Houthis began strikes against ships in the Red Sea in November.
Nalulungkot po talaga, talagang grabe, kasi na kasama po namin ng ilang ano yun eh, yung mga nandoon na pagsaluhan namin ng mga ano mga salo-salo ganyan tas ano po kaya biglang ganun lang yung mangyayari, so napakasakit din po sa amin lalo na po sa pamilya.
We continue to extend and reassure the families of our two seafarers who were slain dito sa missile attack last March 6. Rest assured that the President has ordered the government agencies here before you this evening to provide the fullest assistance within our authority in order to provide the foremost welfare and protective service programs and services to our dear OFW seafarers and their families.
The Philippine Foreign Affairs Department, meanwhile, says it has reached a deal with the International Transport Workers Federation for Filipino seafarers to have the right to refuse deployments in high-risk areas. Let's now get an update on the weather from PAGASA forecaster Rhea Torres. Good morning, Rhea.
Good morning, Bettina, and as well as our televiewers. As of the moment, the shear line is affecting the eastern sections of central and southern Luzon, bringing cloudy skies with scattered rain showers and thunderstorms over Isabela, Quirino, Aurora, and the northern portion of Quezon. Meanwhile, due to the effects of the northeast monsoon, Cordillera and the rest of Cagayan Valley will be experiencing cloudy skies with light rains. Meanwhile, partly cloudy to cloudy skies with isolated light rains may also be experienced over the areas of Ilocos Region and the rest of central Luzon. For the rest of the country, including Metro Manila, generally fair weather conditions are still expected, besides chances of isolated rain showers or thunderstorms, usually by the afternoon or the evening. We currently have no gale warning raised, and we are not monitoring any tropical cyclones or low-pressure area within and outside our Philippine area of responsibility. So for the next few days until this coming weekend, we're expecting generally fair weather conditions to persist over large portions of the country over the next few days. Temperatures in Metro Manila will be ranging from 25 to 32 degrees Celsius, 15 to 24 for Baguio City, Metro Cebu 26 to 31, and for Metro Davao 24 to 32 degrees Celsius. And that is the latest here from PAGASA Weather Forecasting Center. This is Rhea Torres reporting.
Thank you very much for that update, Rhea.